So hello everybody, good evening. Hope everybody is safe and healthy. And to begin with the webinar, I'll introduce myself to all of you. I'm Akriti, born and brought up in a small place called Okhra. It's in West Bengal, 3 hours away from Calcutta. I'm 29 years of age, got married recently last year, settled in Jalandhar right now. I'm working as a counselor. I'm a psychologist, psychotherapist, and a life skills trainer. And I have an experience of more than 5 years. And I'm presently working as a school counselor with Sanskriti KMV School in Jalandhar. And also I've worked as a psychologist trainer, a social activist with the CSR project in Mumbai. And also I've been working with adults and children closely. Today I would actually like to thank Ignani for providing me with this a platform and helping me to reach out to all of you. So today's topic is actually, it's a very simple topic. It just means, you know, first love yourself, but it has a deeper meaning somewhere inside. So before beginning with the webinar, I would actually like to introduce why did I choose this topic particularly, why not other topics? So everybody knows that we humans are very complicated and very complex. We have so much things, you know, kept in our mind. We have so many demands from life, so many expectations from life that we are not, you know, fully satisfied with whatever we have. We always keep on, you know, complaining for every little single thing, whatever it would be. Kabhi kuch chahiye, kabhi is cheez se pareshani hai, we need something, we need that thing. We are always in a mood for competition. Kabhi inse compete karna hai, uske paas ye cheez hai, mere paas kyun nahi hai. Fully satisfied, we cannot stay. Zyada hote hue bhi dikkat hai, kam hote hue bhi dikkat hai. So, you know, deep down the line, once we have achieved everything also, still there's no peace of relaxation left. We keep on wondering, aaj ye karna hai, aaj wo karna hai, aaj isme hai, aaj hum usme hai. So we keep on running between those things. We keep on running behind those things. And that is that point, you know, when you achieve everything in your life, there's one point, there's one, you know, an extent. We come to an extent where we get everything, we get all the pleasures from the life, but we are actually not fully satisfied with the person we are. And then we, you know, keep on cursing ourselves. And then we say to ourselves, ki itna kuch hote hue bhi humne apne liye kuch kiya nahi. So this is the reason I chose the topic fly. Ki first love yourself, accept yourself the way you are, and rest everything will fall in place. So what happens? What are the signs of, you know, what when one can start recognizing that you are not loving yourself deep enough as you should do? So it's actually what happens that when you do not or cannot acknowledge your feelings or accept something about yourself, it's a sign that deep down you do not love yourself. Cheeze hote hue bhi, we do not acknowledge it. We cannot acknowledge our feelings, whatever we are going through. We keep on going through so many of emotions, thoughts, our behavior. You know, we neglect them. We keep on saying ourselves, theek hai, dekhenge, we'll see to it later. But we want to gain, we want to achieve something in our life. And if you do not love yourself, you will never feel completely at peace with yourself and the world around you. Apne se pyar nahi kiya to kisi se nahi kiya. We'll never love ourselves at peace, ever. And we always see something to complain about. Aaj ye nahi hai, aaj wo kami hai, today this is not there. I have so many of complaints from my life. I did everything for others. I did not do anything for myself. We keep on cursing. We keep on blaming ourselves. And we always seem to be less perfect because we think that everybody else is perfect and I am no perfect. So until and unless you cannot learn to love yourself and accept yourself and your feelings, the way you think, you know, the way you behave, the way you feel, you will never be able to fully love by someone else or by either you. So these are some famous quotes being given by some of the famous authors, which says that you should make yourself a priority because at the end of the day, you are your longest commitment. you were born to be real, not to be perfect. And you know, there's this one thing we keep on saying to ourselves, ki kuch kar liya humne, agar kuch galti ho gayi, what will the society say? So it's not about society, it's not about other people, it's all about you. It's you that matters and nothing else. Because at the end of the day, at the end of your life, you came alone, you'll go alone. You'll not take anything with you. So now there are certain reasons that says that why we do not love ourselves. Because aap kuch bhi kar lo apni life mein, whatever you will do in your life, kuch bhi hum kar lein, but our life is not fully complete and we are not fully satisfied. So the first point, there are some of the points that I have listed below, and there are some other points as well. So the first point is that we are always constantly worried about what other people have that we do not have. So what happens in this case is we have set our demands, we have set our expectations from the world, from ourselves, and we have set our demands so high at such a level that at one point of time you keep on running, we keep on going behind it, we want to achieve it at any cost. But at certain age, at certain point of time, you're not able to meet your demands, you're not able to meet your expectations. And that is when we start getting jealous of the other people. We start getting anxious of what other people is achieving and you're not able to achieve. This could be with your personal relationship. This could happen in your office with your colleagues, or anywhere you go. It can happen with the adults, with adolescents, with the kids also in school. Because we have set our demands very high. कि हमने ये चीज अगर करनी है तो हमने करना है. We do not realize the after effects. Because what we do is out of passion, out of anxiety, and out of compulsion, हमने कुछ ठान लिया है तो we'll do it. But हम ये नहीं सोचते कि उसका after effect क्या होगा. What will happen if you're not able to achieve it? And that is the point, when you're not able to achieve your demands, you start blaming yourself. You start hurting yourself. The second point is labeling yourself. This is one of the most crucial, points that is very important, and is one important aspect in which we do not love ourselves, is that we start giving adjectives to our own self. We start calling ourselves, we start bullying ourselves. हम अपने आप को इतने नाम दे जाते हैं कि हमें खुद को realize नहीं होता है what we are doing. For example, you're not able to meet any deadline. You do a particular task and you have committed a small mistake in it. Or dubara when you start doing it, the next time you do it, it's not happening again. Kahin na kahin, somewhere still, you're still lagging. So you start calling yourself as worthless. I am hopeless. I am fool. I am an idiot. I have no purpose. My life has no purpose. And we say it out of, a frustration or out of anger. We do not realize what we are saying, what we are saying to ourselves. But what happens is that deep down in your subconscious mind, you start registering this thing, whatever you say to yourself, it starts registering on your subconscious mind. And it keeps on adding. It keeps on building a pile, one after the other. And once the pile is set, there's an end point, there's a limit to each and everything. So once your limit is reached, you're not able to move ahead. That is how when you start labeling yourself. The third point is you start comparing yourself to others in the form of a materialistic thing. So we see everybody is doing good in their life. We see that your friend is buying a new car, going out on a holiday, spending so much shopping and everything. But what happens is we do not realize the other person's perspective. We always see that the grass is greener on the other side, but it's not on my side. Mere saath hi kyun aisa hota hai that I am not able to buy or do anything new? Why it is always my friend or my family or my relative is succeeding? Main kyun nahi kuch kar pa rahi hu ya kuch nahi kar pa raha hu? So that is when we start comparing ourselves with others. The next point is you're forgetting about what you have that others don't. This is completely related to your skills and your abilities. You and your best friend are working in the same office. You have your particular set of skills. Your friend has a particular different set of skills. your boss, your leader has given you a particular task to do, and you see that your friend has completed it in a short span of time, whereas you are not able to, you know, do your task in a given time. This could be because of various reasons. You know, maybe there could be a family emergency, you have some important work to do, right? Or else, you know, the task which your boss gave requires much more additional information as compared to your friend. But nee, what we do is we start on you know, comparing ourselves with your friend. We say that usne itni jaldi kaise kar liya when the boss has given the same work to both of us. Maybe your friend has not shared what the boss has given the work, but we keep on making a perception, you know, that both the tasks were same. Boss ne usko bhi same task diya, mujhko bhi same task diya, but main kyun nahi kar paya ya main kyun nahi kar paya. The next point is your past still haunts you. You curse yourself, you hold back your past experience, which may be due to a very bad childhood, a bad relationship, something has happened in the deep past, some trauma, and you're not able to move out of it. And that is what it is holding you back, because you are not able to go. You're not able to move forward of what has happened in your life. You stop because you care too much about other people's opinion. Especially in India, especially with the ladies, if you can relate, there's one thing which is called society. Ki agar humne kuch kar diya, if we do something, what others will think, what society will think. Society is not there to judge you. What matters is you, how do you do it, and then your family supports you or not. So there's a fear in us, you know, whatever we want to do, we feel that nahi, agar ye humne kuch kar diya, toh log kuch bura bol denge, somebody will say bad about us, somebody will have a bad opinion, somebody will say what I am doing, look, she's doing this thing, look, he's doing this thing. Humne logon ka itna parwaah karte hain, we think so much about other people that, you know, we do not care about ourselves. You want to eat, you like eating, you're a big foodie. आपको खाने में चीजें अच्छी लगती है. यू गो इन अ रेस्टोरेंट, यू स्टार्ट ईटिंग, यू नो, यू लाइक आइसक्रीम, यू ईट आइसक्रीम, बट देन व्हेन यू ईट टू मच, एक स्कूप खाने के बाद, दो स्कूप खाने के बाद, यू रियलाइज कि अरे ज्यादा खा लिया, व्हाट विल अदर पीपल से. दैट इज नॉट द केस. यू हैव टू बी हैप्पी, यू हैव टू कीप योरसेल्फ हैप्पी, यू कैन नॉट कीप एवरीबॉडी हैप्पी. दैट्स नॉट योर जॉब, दैट्स नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ योर लाइफ. And the last point is the lack of trust yourself, your own intuition, your own compass. You know, you do not trust yourself in whatever you do. Kuch bhi karte hain, hame apne mein doubt aata hai. We keep on doubting ourselves. Main kar paungi, main kar paunga, ye mujhse hoga, ye mujhse nahi hoga. I'm not able to do it. I cannot do it because I'm a terrible person. Whatever I do, I make mistakes in it. I'm useless. I'm worthless. Your intuition says, your gut feeling says, go do it. You know, you can do it. But there's something which holds you back. It says, nahi, if you do it, something bad will happen. So I cannot do it. So these are the blocks which actually, you know, come in between when you start making yourself apart from you. Okay. Now, these are some photographs. It says that you are a failure. Says I'm not worth it. Am I? There's this lady who is cribbing, crying. And this is what looks like once you start hating yourself, that you do not want to see yourself in front of the mirror or in front of anybody else. So this is a small video which I'll play again, which shows that what are the major reasons that makes you hate yourself, makes you not fall in love with yourself? Have a look.
Hi, everyone. Before we begin this video, we'd like to give a big thank you for your love and support. Here at Psych2Go, our mission is to make psychology and mental health more accessible to everyone. Do you feel like no matter what you do or where you go, there's an unexplained feeling within you that you're not good enough and a total failure at everything? Even when you've achieved something or are given love and affection, you can't help but brush it off because of the self-loathing voice within you that tells you, who do you think you are? You're nobody. Do you think all this could be because you hate yourself? If so, here are 7 common reasons why you might feel that way. 1. You had a bad childhood. Growing up in a toxic home environment and living with a dysfunctional family can be extremely damaging to a person's mental health and self-esteem. Usually, toxic families are either too strict and controlling or indifferent and neglectful. As young children, we can't help but think that the reason behind this is our fault and everything our parents do are right. We look up to them. We grow up wanting their love, attention, respect, and approval. And the more it's denied, the more we desire it. Want to know more? You can watch our video titled 8 Ways Your Childhood Affects Your Lifestyle. 2. You had a rough time at school. Were you ever bullied by anyone? Do you struggle to fit in and make friends? Social crises like these can cultivate feelings of shame, self-doubt, and self-hatred. You'll start to ask yourself, why is this happening to me? And why don't people like me? Is there something wrong with me? 3. You struggle with past trauma. Is there a specific incident in your past that caused you to feel this way? It doesn't necessarily have to be from childhood. Maybe it was the absenteeism of a parent, a nasty breakup, the death of a loved one, or an abusive relationship. People tend to define themselves based on their experiences in life. When something terrible happens to you, it's hard not to feel as if you deserve it. Thus, the trauma of your negative past experiences can manifest as denial, defeat, or self-hatred. 4. You feel disconnected. This reason is much more philosophical than the rest, but it takes its roots from existential psychology. One of the pioneers of this field, Rollo Rees-May, believed that self-hatred is what happens when we become too egocentric and focused on ourselves. It leads to a feeling of disconnect between us, others, and the world. This leads to feelings of unexplained loneliness, emptiness, and meaninglessness. When we think too much about everything only from our point of view and fail to realize our place in the universe, we deny ourselves the opportunity to fulfilling our greatest potential and thus unknowingly hate ourselves for it. 5. You don't have social support. Based on a study by Kleeman and Liu in 2013, social support has been shown to be a very important protective factor against trauma and depression. So, when you have no one in your life who you can count on to be there for you in times of distress and emotional need, it further reinforces your feelings of self-loathing. From family to friends to colleagues, a lack of meaningful intimate relationships in your life can make it harder for you to feel loved, cared for, and accepted. 6. You're always comparing yourself to others. Do you find yourself comparing yourself to other people and competing with them to be better? It's emotionally exhausting. The unhealthy need to feel superior to others and setting unrealistically high expectations for ourselves only makes us feel worse about ourselves when we fail to measure up to them. In fact, research has found that more social media exposure often results in symptoms of depression, loneliness, and anxiety. While detoxifying and disconnecting from it for a short while has been proven to improve our happiness and peace of mind. And 7, you have a negative self-concept. Finally, and most importantly, the reason why you hate yourself could be because of your negative self-concept. According to R.B. Burns, an author of The Self-Concept, in theory, measurement, development, and behavior, self-concept is defined as a person's view of themselves that's based on their values, principles, experiences, and relationships. When you choose to define yourself according to the bad things in your life, be it traumatic experience, dysfunctional family, or mistreatment at school, you're internalizing all the negativity and convincing yourself that you're a terrible person. In focusing solely on the ugly parts of your life, you discount all the good things about you and all the wonderful things in your life. You're allowing all of those horrible things to have power over you and dictate how you feel about yourself. Does this sound familiar? There's no quick fix to overcoming your self-hatred, especially if you've been struggling with it for a long time now. Feelings of insecurity don't just disappear overnight. But the good news is that we don't have to resign ourselves to such a miserable fate, because with time, hard work, and dedication, it gets better. The first step to the road to recovery is to understand the reason why you hate yourself and to come to terms with it. Do you relate to any of these points explained in the video? What other reasons did we miss out on? Let us know in the comments below. Also, don't forget to share this video with someone who might benefit from it. like this video, and subscribe for more psychology content. As always, thanks for watching.
So this is the all video related to why we do not love ourselves. Now, if somebody has gone through such experience that, you know, we are feeling not feeling good about yourself, we're not feeling happy about yourself, there are certain ways in which you can actually start loving yourself over again, all over again. So it's called FLY. It's called First Love Yourself. And there's I'll explain you certain points which will help you, or which can actually be some additional benefits, additional value based points that can actually help you with your life. So the first comes is unconditional self acceptance. Now, as a human being, we all know that it's very easy. That we can actually pinpoint others' mistake easily, and we do not pinpoint our own mistake. Usually what happens is whenever you have committed any mistake, if we do any mistakes and we know that we are to be blamed and there was some other person also involved with you, what we do is we pinpoint him, we pinpoint her, and we say ki wo uski galti thi, uske wajah se ye cheez bura hua. And we don't accept ki hamari bhi usme galti thi. Uski galti thi to thi, but ठीक है आपने भी गलती की है, वी ऑल्सो डिड अ मिस्टेक. सो व्हाट वी डू इज वी इग्नोर ऑल आवर मिस्टेक्स, वी इग्नोर ऑल आवर नेगेटिव सेल्फ, एंड यू नो वी ओनली फोकस ऑन अ पॉजिटिव आउटकम्स, वी ओनली फोकस ऑन अ पॉजिटिव.
इट लुक्स लाइक देयर इज सम टेक्निकल एरर एट आकृति's एंड. लेट्स जस्ट वेट फॉर अ मिनट. Akriti, can you hear us?
Whatever it is, your crooked teeth, or maybe you do not look good, but you need to accept that. You need to accept whatever you are, as you are. If you're very, if you get angry very easily, you need to accept that, yes, I get angry, I'm very short-tempered. You just cannot ignore that part. And if you're very good also, so you do not have to take advantage of that, that I'm very kind, I'm very helpful, main bahut hi thehra insaan hoon, aur us cheez ka aapko ghamand nahi hona chahiye. You should not take it, in such a level ki aap aaspaas ki cheezon ko bhool jate ho. So you have to be like really very balanced. You need to practice radical honesty. And when you can admit your own pretense, you can begin to powerfully create a new future. Admit your honesty. अपने हिस्से की ईमानदारी रखिए. आप कुछ भी गलत कर रहे हैं या आपने कुछ भी वो किया, आप उसको ईमानदारी से कहिए कि हाँ, I have committed a mistake. It's very difficult to say a lie, because एक झूठ बोलने से you have to say 100 lies. So it's better to accept whatever you have done and be honest. Be honest in whatever you do. Be honest to yourself. Honest to your own soul, your own inner self. Admit your mistakes first rather than pinpointing others' mistake. Khud ki galtiyan accept karo pehle, dusron ki galtiyon ko baad mein pinpoint karna. Own your outcome. Whatever is happening with you, whatever life is giving you, you need to accept that. Because it's only you, to be blamed. So whatever it's happening, you need to own your own outcomes. Don't let fear get in your way. Because jo dar gaya so mar gaya, aur dar ke aage jeet hai. So you have to be very adamant, you have to be like very strong, and you have to let fear get out of your way. Dar se kuch nahi hoga. If it's okay, if you do a mistake, galti ho bhi jati hai, to theek hai. Every human being who is on earth is not perfect. But the way you do a mistake, ab jaise bhi hai, you're perfectly perfect. Count on your competencies. Let go of your biases. Stop labeling yourself. Accept that struggle will always be a part of your reality. Itna aap yaad rakhi ki, there will be always struggle. You have to face through a lot of hardship, because your life is not a bed of roses. Make a plan for reaching your goal. What we usually do is we take very nasty decisions and very hasty decisions. Or hum ने सोचा है तो हमने वो करना ही है. एंड फॉर टू रीच आवर गोल्स इफ यू वांट टू अचीव समथिंग वी कैन डू एनीथिंग टू डू दैट. चाहे वो इधर से हो जाए वो उधर से हो जाए, यू कमिट सो मेनी मिस्टेक्स, आप अपने आप से धोखेदारी करते हैं, एंड यू वांट टू रीच योर गोल. सो बी पेशेंट इनफ, टेक बेबी स्टेप्स इन रीचिंग योर गोल. Remember snakes and ladder. When you play snake and ladder, what happens? That you want to reach to the 100th level, but the snake comes in between. He bites you. The snake bites you, and you come down. So we do not give up so easily. We play. So life is also like that. सांप सीढ़ी की तरह है. आपको खेलते रहना पड़ेगा. So this is how your life would look like once you have unconditionally accepted yourself. So your life is actually happening into three phases. There's a phase one approach, which is called self-awareness. It is a holistic approach that enables you to understand yourself as a whole. So you introspect yourself, you spend time with yourself, you understand what you are going through, what you want to change in your life, and accordingly, you take actions. The second is self-acceptance. Through forgiveness and healing, you are now able to love yourself unconditionally. So you forgive yourself, you heal yourself, you do your positive reinforcement, a negative reinforcement, you go for your healing processes, chakras ke saath, reiki, and then, you know, you are accepting yourself. You are now on a level that you are starting loving yourself unconditionally. And once you are self-aware of yourself completely and you have self-accepted yourself as a whole, as a person you are, so now you will start living an authentic living, in which you will hold a clear perception on your strengths, on your motivations, and now you are ready to lead a good life. The second point is irrational thoughts versus rational thoughts. Now, our mind actually plays a very important role in controlling our emotions, our ways of thinking, our thought process, and our behaviors. It's only because of our mind that we are able to control whatever we say. So what happens is that once we start hating ourselves, we start getting irrational thoughts. And how does the irrational thoughts come in? And how can you stop it? So you need to identify the event that is making you yourself feel sorry, disappointed, frustrated, annoyed, or self-defeating, horrified, panicking, anxiety, depressed, or self-hating. Now, after the event has been identified, you have to check what has led you to think about that event, or what was the event that happened. Now, the event could be an external situation. It could be a thought, feeling, any of your internal event. It could be referred to the event which has happened in the past, in the present, or in the future. After you have identified your event, what has, or any specific situation that has caused you to think into an irrational way of thinking, you need to identify that irrational beliefs and negative thought patterns. What are your irrational beliefs about yourself that you are holding for yourself? Or what are the negative thought processes that is coming on your mind? And you can see that your negative thought process or your irrational belief will automatically change your emotional and behavioral aspects. Dealing with your emotions becomes very difficult. Your behavior is also affected, because it is actually a three-way process. The way you think affects your emotions, which affects your behavior, and then affects the way of thinking. So it's a three-way process. Then you can see that your beliefs are very rigid or very dysfunctional. You can have a belief of the world is bad, I'm bad, everything is bad, nothing is happening according to my choice, everything should happen according to my way. So these are your beliefs. So it can be very rigid. You are very rigid of whatever you are thinking. You want to go, your life should happen this way, so it should happen this way. It must happen, so it must happen. And it's very dysfunctional. And lastly, you will see that your emotional consequences, your beliefs. You will start crying, you will start sobbing, you'll start shouting, you'll start hating yourself, you hurt yourself in the form of cards. This is generally seen that usually what the adult, what the clients do, or what the person does once the emotional consequences to their beliefs is not this, it's not functional. It's dysfunctional and it's rigid. So once you have identified your emotional, your irrational fears, your irrational beliefs, you can actually dispute them. You can actually challenge them. You can actually put in yourself, you can frame yourself a question that if I think that I'm feeling bad about myself, if I'm unworthy or I'm not very good, but where it is written that I am bad or I'm incapable of doing anything, there are no proof. There is no proof. It is what that I have settled in my mind. And once you start challenging your own beliefs, your own thought process, you will see that the old beliefs has been replaced by the new irrational, the rational beliefs. So now this is the chart. This are some of the sentences which shows that how irrational it is and how you can convert it into a rational thought. So the first one reads as how awful. Now awful is something which is very bad. It's very negative. It's awfulizing, haw, aw, something which is very, which denotes a very negative connotation. But once you replace the word awful with disappointing, disappointing is also negative, but not that much negative. It's unhealthy emotion. Awful is unhealthy. Disappointing is healthy. I cannot stand it. It's frustration. It's your frustration is coming out. I cannot stand him. I cannot see him. I cannot do this thing. I cannot just do it. But you can replace that by saying, I do not like it, but I'll deal it. I'll deal with it. Yeah, we say, so now that is very healthy. That I do not like it. I do not like this process, or I do not like this person at all, but it's okay. I'll deal with him. I am stupid. That is, you know, downsizing yourself. You are downing yourself in front of everyone, in front of you, in front of your eyes, in front of the society. But you can replace it by this thought. What I did was stupid. So, ठीक है, एक तो आपने कुछ गलती की, आप उसके बारे में you are cursing yourself. बट आप उसको ये कह रहे हो कि मैं नहीं हूं जो स्टूपिड हूं, बट वट एवर आई डिड, वट एवर वर्ड और वट एवर वर्क आई डिड वो स्टूपिड. ही स्टिंक्स. नाउ स्टिंक्स इज, कभी भी कोई आपको अगर कहता है ई, यू नो, यूर स्मेलिंग, यूर स्टिंकिंग, सो यू फील सो बैड अबाउट इट. वी फील अशेम कि यार कैसे बोल दिया तुमने. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ, यू नो, इफ यू एवर से ही स्टिंक्स और आप किसी को भी कुछ ऐसा बोलने जा रहे हैं, सो से दैट ठीक है, ही इज नॉट परफेक्ट ईदर. Everybody stinks. ठीक है, everybody stinks. It's when it's very summery, you go out, you know, and you're sitting in a, you know, traveling by train or anything, everybody stinks. So ठीक है, किसी को ऐसे pinpoint नहीं करना है. So you just need to say he's not perfect either. Simple. This should not be happening. So this should and must are the two words which makes you think in an irrational way. This should not be happening. कैसे हो गया ये हो ही नहीं सकता मेरे साथ. अरे ऐसे कैसे हो गया, दिस कैन नॉट हैपन. सो ठीक है, दिस हैड हैपन सिंस इट, दिस हैड टू हैपन सिंस इट डिड. जो होना था तो होना है, ठीक है, हो गया, छोड़ो, देखते हैं, वी विल सी क्या हो सकता है. आई एम टू बी ब्लेम्ड. सो अगेन दिस इज एन इरेशनल थॉट. यू आर अगेन, यू नो, ब्लेमिंग योरसेल्फ. आई एम एट फॉल्ट बट नॉट टू बी ब्लेम्ड. So we're just talking about irrational and rational thoughts. So this irrational sentence, I am to be blamed. You did not do any mistake. आपने कुछ ऐसा कि गलत काम किया ही नहीं, कि इतना बड़ा कोई गलत काम किया ही नहीं, that you are to be blamed. कोई चोरी नहीं की, किसी को मारा नहीं. It's just that you are at fault. कोई गलती mistake अगर होगी तो you are at fault, but not to be blamed. Things always go wrong. ऐसा नहीं है कि always things go wrong. आप कभी कुछ करते तो थोड़ा बहुत गलत हो जाता है. It happens with everyone. So it should be like something. Sometimes things go wrong. Things never work out. Aisa nahi ki aap kuch bhi kar rahe ho to things do not work out. What happens is more or less things do not work out. I should have done better. Theek hai. Karna tha, next time I'll try. So you say, I wish I did better, but I tried my best. So now the next point is, after discussing all the irrational versus the rational thoughts, the next point is to be positive in your life. So you need to be positive in everything you do. You need to find out an optimistic viewpoint in a negative situation. Cultivate and live in a positive environment. Go slowly, take baby steps, do whatever you're doing, but be positive in that. Do not let your vague fears hold you back from doing whatever you want to do. add value and positivity to someone else's life. You know, talk to someone, speak to somebody, give them inspiration, be inspiration for them as well. And do not brag about yourself. Do not keep on cursing about yourselves in front of them. Exercise regularly, eat and sleep well. Always learn to take criticism in a healthy way. So after the seminar, I think sir would be asking you, or I would be asking you, how did the seminar go? So if you say to me that the seminar did not go in a good way, or we did not like your points, or you were not so confident enough, I not take it in a negative way, I take it in a healthy way. So it can actually help me for the next seminar, the next webinar. And always start your day in a very positive way. Now the next is, this is how you should be thinking positive, because thinking positive will lead you, will make you feel encouraged, happy, motivated, strong, determined, imaginative, optimistic. And then you should start, you know, stop comparing yourself with others. Do not compare yourself with others. So if she's also awesome, then you're also super awesome. This is how it goes. So you need to water your own grass, be content and satisfied with whatever you have. Okay. Accept where you are. Remember, change is only constant. If you're stuck in a particular situation, you're not moving ahead, you see your life is not taking a good turn, it's not happening in such a good way. So remember, change will happen. You know, time will come when you will also lead a good life. Love your past. Do not let your past, you know, you ignore your past. No. Love your past. Whatever happened in your past is past. Now it's gone. Focus on your present and then think of the future. Do a social media detox sometimes, because Instagram and Facebook is one of the most important reasons when we start hating ourselves, because we start comparing. We see other people feeds, we see other people posts, and what we do is we start comparing our lives with them. But we do not see what is happening on the other side. Maybe they are not very happy with each other, or maybe they are not very, you know, they're not, you know, partying, or they're not going out somewhere. It's just that they have put up a poster to make other people feel jealous. Know that this is not the end of the movie. Be grateful for what you have. Realize you're not perfect. Turn comparison into inspiration. Stop shoulding and stop should and must yourself, and always compare yourself with you. This is how you are. You are a God's favorite child. The grass is greener on the other side. Water your own grass. I'm unique, special, and I'm superhero. And the last is, spend some me time with yourself. Because what matters is you and nothing else. And everybody deserves some me time. Spend some quality time with yourself. Compliment yourself. Say good things about yourself. Feel happy. Write letters to you. Write love letters to you. Change the way you make decisions. Think from your heart sometimes. Go cloud watching, stargazing, birds. Play. Do whatever you want to. If you're going to work, you always take the same route. Try discovering new route. But then also see that you do not end up stuck in a traffic jam or you get lost. Meditate, practice yoga, water plants, do gardening. This is what I have started doing now, right? Days. I started gardening. I started making plants my friend. I speak to them, you know, I talk to them. Narrow your food choices, cut down on your food. Whatever you want to eat, you eat. Whatever you don't want to, you don't want to. Write down your thought process. Have a self date. Go out on a coffee date. You know, go watch movie alone. Sometimes it actually works. Take a home spa. Plan holiday, paint, pamper yourself sometimes, go to on a salon, go for a hair wash or for a manicure, pedicure, whatever you want to. You know, men should also go, and then they should go for a home spa, enjoy, relax, pamper yourself sometimes, cook, enjoy sunshine, and also talk to yourself, even if it sounds crazy. You should talk to yourself. Stand in the mirror, talk to yourself, sing, dance, do whatever you want to. Because at the end, it's only you who matter. And give yourselves the same care and attention that you have given to others, and watch yourself too.
I like being you. said the reflection in the mirror. To me, you are perfectly perfect. I blushed. Me? Yes, you. And by the way, you have wonderful eyes. I blinked, astonished. I do? Absolutely. They sparkle like stars on the darkest of nights. I gazed downward. Thank you. Your eyes sparkle too. Sweet of you to say. You have a marvelous voice. I gently whispered. You really think so? Of course. You sound as joyous as a songbird, whistling in the trees. And you have a magnificent smile. I sheepishly grinned. Well, Mama always says, start every day with a smile. I agree. Your smile is as bright and cheerful as the sun in the sky. And you are quite smart. I took a step towards the mirror. I do try very hard. You sure do. You're as brilliant as a rocket scientist. I like that you are friendly. I leaned in closer. It's very important to be nice, you know. It sure is. You're as peaceful as a butterfly. And you have a lot of courage. I raised my head high. I auditioned for the school play today. Outstanding. You're as brave as a lion. You're a fantastic dancer. Wide. Watch how fast I can twirl. Around and around I went. Amazing. You're as graceful as a dolphin gliding through the sea. I plopped on the ground, giggling as the room playfully spun around. And you have a terrific laugh. Thank you very much. Your chuckle fills the air with bubbly joy. But most of all, I like your heart. Your kindness is as beautiful as a rainbow. I stood up and walked towards the mirror. To me.
Did you all see the video, sir? Were you able to see the video?
Yeah, towards the end, it got stuck for some reason, but it's okay. We can move on with this slide, and then we'll start taking the question answers.
Sure. So this was all about loving yourself, because it clearly says that, you know, you should be my favorite home. Don't forget to pamper yourself, love yourself unconditionally. And be ready for the question and answers also.
All right. So request to participants. You can ask questions related to this particular topic. Please type in your questions in the chat box and we'll try to direct those questions to Akriti. On the screen, you will see some of the books that she recommends. Yes, please go ahead, Akriti.
Yeah, these are some books which has actually helped me a lot in learning about myself. So you may also go through this book, you can read them. And also there's, you know, it also actually depends on how the way you're taking your your perspectives also. So it's up to you how, you know, the way you want to accept yourself also. So books are also, it's a sort of a helping hand, but it solely depends on you. And thank you everybody for actually giving me this opportunity. I'm so sorry in the meanwhile, the connections, we lost on the connections part. This is the first time I'm doing a webinar. So I'm sorry if I had done any mistakes or something, you may actually see me. So I'll take it as a compliment, which will help me for the other webinar. For any, personal help or for any psychotherapy or any life skills training, or also for any one-to-one counseling session, you may actually email me on hana.akriti@gmail.com, or you may actually also WhatsApp me on the given number on the screen. And you may also raise your questions here related to this particular topic also, as Sir said. And for any other personal inquiries or for any other personal related help, you may actually get in touch with me.
So you all can make a note of this, her contact details, in case if you feel that there is someone you know who might need some assistance. She offers her services as a counselor. You can directly get in touch with her without Ignani being a mediator. You can take a screenshot of her contact details.
Or so they may actually contact you also, and then we can actually, you know, if you don't want.
Yes,
to...
yeah, that way also it's okay. We have Pallavi says she wants to take a look at the slides of the books, the recommended books once again. So
sure.
If you can just move. Yeah.
Yeah.
You can also take a screenshot of this or make a note of these books. And all these books are amazing books, great books. Meanwhile, other participants, if you have any questions, please use the chat box to write your questions. We have another 4 to 5 minutes left, and we'll try and cover whatever questions comes in. Okay, Akriti, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
We have one question coming from Soumya.
Right.
She says, in amidst of Corona, how can we motivate ourselves with the same routine as a housewife?
Okay. Thank you, Soumya, for giving me this opportunity to actually help you. First of all, this pandemic has created a lot of mess in everybody's life. But to remind you that you are not the only one who is suffering from this pandemic. Everybody is going through the same, the same life. Sabke saath ye ho raha hai abhi. And everybody is actually, going through the same routine through this pandemic. Especially as a housewife, I can actually understand. What you may do is you can actually start giving, denoting your side, your time to, yourself. Maybe you can pick up some hobby like painting or, going for a walk. As I said, you may do gardening, pick up some plants, do house gardening, home gardening. And you may also, whatever passion you had it in the past, which you want to continue, please go ahead, do that. Also speak to your partner, speak to your husband that you want to do this thing, play games with your daughter, with your children at home, especially if you want, if you love cooking also. So you may try out different recipes. So I think this would actually help you.
All right. We have one more question coming from Priyanka.
Mm-hmm.
She says, if anyone pulls us always, you can't do this, you can't do that, then what steps to be taken? What steps can we take in order to deal with this problem?
Okay. So, hi, Priyanka. Thank you again for this opportunity. So, as you said, that if somebody pulls you continuously and says that you cannot do something or you cannot do anything. See, now everybody has a right to speak. Everybody can say something or the other. But it depends on the way how you take it. So as I told you that even if somebody is telling you something that you cannot do anything or you cannot do everything, you know that you can do it, right? You do not need any certification or any authentication for a thing that aapse ye kuch hoga nahi, aapse ye kuch nahi kar paoge ya aap nahi kar sakte ho. So, the person has a habit. The other person might have a habit of saying this always. So, okay, ignore it. You know that you cannot change the other person, but you can change yourself. So start ignoring those things. ठीक है उसे मत ध्यान दीजिए ठीक है if I even say आपके आसपास अगर वो बार बार आपको आके कह रहे हैं कि it's happening ऐसा है pulling you down continuously, ignore that thing, don't take it in your heart and take it as a compliment. ठीक है वो मेरे को कह रहे हैं ठीक है I'll prove him wrong someday, but I do not have to prove him wrong in a very immediate way. So out of hasty decisions, do not go and do something else. But take it slowly. Ignore that person's, ignore it. Because the person might have a habit of saying it always. So ignore karo and then concentrate on whatever you are doing and don't take it on your heart.
Great. Thank you, Akriti. We'll take just one or two more questions. One question coming from Reshma.
Mm-hmm.
She's asking, can you suggest some affirmations to build or boost our confidence when we are low?
Okay. So, there are certain affirmations which I would actually recommend when your confidence is low. So, I said that, you should always remember that you are no less than other being, okay? So, continuously, you have to keep it in your mind. You have to say it to yourself that, okay, whatever is happening, whatever you're doing is, theek hai, I'll do it, mistake, hoga mere se galti, but I am no less than somebody else. I can do it and I will do it. And then again, you may read some self-help books, these books, take notes of this. You may actually get in help with any of the therapists or, set yourself, set some time, think, look at your thought pattern, concentrate on your thought pattern, write it down, see where you lack, what do you want to change in it, and then you may proceed it accordingly.
Great. I think we are done with the time. We have one last question here. I don't know the name of the person. It comes up on the screen as Galaxy A20. The question is, how can I fly when my wings are controlled by my loved ones?
Okay. So thank you for this question. Very important question when you say that your wings are being controlled by your loved ones. So everybody, we all know that our parents or our family members have an immense love on us. They share immense love on us, which does not mean that they'll not let you fly. So even if they're controlling you, you should go speak to them, ask them, you know, that what are the reasons why you do not want me to fly? What is happening? Like, where I'm lacking behind? Do you find any fault in me? What do you want to change in me? So it's almost like you sit with your family members, speak to them, ask them what is that, you know, what is the bridge that is, you know, gap, or what is the bridge that is happening that is making you both apart? So spend some time with your family members, speak to them, and then only you can actually start loving or start flying.
All right, great. That's it. We don't have any more questions. So thank you so much, Akriti, for a wonderful presentation. I hope it has benefited some of our participants. It was all about all positive living and positive thinking. So thank you once again, and thank you to all the participants. And we'll try and bring more of such webinars for you in the future as well.